I've been tattooing roughly 20 years. I started in 97, I believe. I was always into artwork ever since I was a kid. So I've always drawn and I've always done art and I've always admired art. So I always had in my head that I was going to be an artist. I was going to do something like that. I didn't really consider tattooing until, you know, later in high school. I had a bunch of friends that they wanted to get tattooed. And I always thought tattoos were cool, but I wasn't that concentrated on that. I was more into like comic books and things like that. So, but they'd always come to me and be like, hey, draw this out so I can go get this tattooed. And I'm, okay, cool, draw some stuff. And then they would usually go to some questionable tattoo person because they weren't of age and then, you know, get this image tattooed. And I remember it struck me early that they would come back and like, look, got this tattooed and it looked horrible. And I was like, that's not at all what I drew, you know? Like, how could they do that? So that was my first like inclination that who's doing the tattoo matters. And, you know, that there's some art in that, you know, that it, there's some skill that needs to happen for them to pull it off.
One of the main things that got me into tattooing was one of my best friends up in State College, Pennsylvania. He had his tattoo studio up there. He still does. But he's the one that kind of really pushed me to kind of expand what I was doing into another field of art. So, yeah, a lot of fun. Compared to what I was doing, I airbrushed on the boardwalk for close to 16 years. So that was a lot of painting on in the summers, mainly doing the touristy stuff, the t-shirts, the vanity plates, things like that. In the winter, I hooked up with a couple guys around the area, a couple guys up by Cambridge area, and I was actually doing some top-end hot rods, motorcycle tanks, bikes, and stuff like that for a few years. I got it published into a couple different magazines by different vehicles that I painted and everything like that. So. Pretty much been in the art field almost all my life.
The equipment is a little more precise now than it used to be. So more colors are available, more equipment, so you can do more details than you could maybe 24 years ago. And there's better artists out there, so it just keeps evolving into more of a fine art form, I would say.
It's partly artistic, I think. Like, I'm a very visual person and I really admire visual things, and I think that tattooed bodies are beautiful, and so I think that kind of led me to wanting to start getting like these kind of beautiful markings on my body in different places. Of course, because I spend all my time with books and words, I have that, but I also just wanted things that were beautiful, and it's okay to have things that are beautiful because they're beautiful. You don't have to have deeper meaning, and in the end they all serve as this kind of archive of your life and different moments of your life.
I started getting tattoos about 5 years ago. I waited until pretty late in life. I always wanted a tattoo, but I couldn't commit. And then it just hit me that you didn't have to necessarily love the image forever. Yeah. They sort of marked a period of time as well as anything else. So that's when I just went, okay, I'm going to get a tattoo and I'm not going to worry about whether I will like it for the rest of my life. You just say, I'm going to do this, and then you live with it.
So if I were sitting down just doing my artwork and I wasn't dealing with another person and their input, right, then I might make slightly different decisions and just basically do what I like, right? But with tattooing, you know, it's a merging of ideas. So, you know, it's about the artist and like how they do things, and then like the client and what they're looking to get out of it. So, you know, they'll bring a lot of pieces to the table, and then I'll bring what I know that I can make look good to the table, and we're kind of merging those ideas together. So much like if someone were to, like I feel like it's much like if someone were to contract a painter to do a painting, you know, they're not gonna, they're basically going to that painter to get his rendition of this idea, you know? And that's how I feel the best way to approach tattoos is.
I do love tattooing. It is a lot of fun. Sometimes just sitting down with a client, figuring out what they want to do. A lot of the clients will bring in like almost references, a lot of references and stuff like that. So we kind of sit down with them and go through. We start nitpicking as to, okay, this might be a better tattoo idea than this idea, and you know, work off of that. And then once we get down to like the main nitty gritty of what the tattoo is going to be, if it's going to represent anything, their base niche on it, then that's where I like to have a lot of fun and just start researching that tattoo, you know, finding out like if there's different meanings and stuff like that into the tattoo, where I can bring those in, kind of maybe bring that element out a little bit more in the tattoo. And so yeah, I'd say the designing part of it is a lot of fun. Also tattooing it is a lot of fun, and then listening to this, like some of the stories that people have behind the tattoo or reasons why they have that tattoo. So yeah, I love the whole experience of it.
Well, I have to say the most challenging part for me in any tattoo is the very beginning, like the first tattoo session. It's also in some ways very exciting session, because there's a lot of decisions to be made, size, placement, how one part is working with another. There's so many things to think about, and you know, you're thinking of that end result while putting all these pieces together. So it can get complex. And that's where there's a little bit of, you know, I don't want to say nerves, but like there's so many decisions that you just, and they're all going to look good. You're just trying to pick out what you like the best, you know, what you think is going to end up the best. So there's a lot to do the first session. I don't know that that's necessarily like fun, the most fun, session. Probably when you're finishing up and doing the last final touches and seeing it all come together, oftentimes that last session, like all the like the highlights and then those last little shadows, like the little final tricks are what really turn it up.
It is so cute.
Kind of when I was getting tattooed, I had to make sure everything was covered. That way, coming out of college, going into the workforce, everything had to be non-seen. I know I went into several interviews where people had tattoos and they were coming out after the interview, and just, I'd go in, talk with the guy. I was like, well, how was the guy from? And they're like, he was very well qualified, but he has tattoos. We can't hire him. And that was the big stigma, was a lot of people saw tattoos and just thought, you know, oh, he's the biker, or he's from the bad side of town, stuff like that, you know, just brought in that like almost kind of cliche of what a tattooed or a tattooed person would, you know, kind of represent. But coming into now, especially with, you had, I guess, the 80s hit, and then you had the glam rock, so everybody was tattooed, so that kind of brought that into a little bit of the limelight now with all the tattoo shows and stuff like that. So it's definitely come a very long way. They're not looked on as I guess, you know, the old school tattoos where, you know, that, you know, you want to stay away from that person. Now they're more artwork. They're seen more as artwork.
A lot has changed since I've started tattooing. And even when I came in, things were starting to change. To where, you know, I wouldn't say it was nearly as acceptable as it is now, but, you know, more people were starting to get tattooed. And also more people that were doing tattoos were coming from different arenas. So we have more people that were starting to come in from, say, art school backgrounds and things like that, which typically didn't happen much before that. So they were bringing with them art techniques and concepts that were different from the traditional tattoo structure. And so that blew up a lot of styles and options for people. When I started, it was still somewhat taboo. Like, it was still, there was no TV shows, there was no window for the average person to like look into this world. I mean, you had to like come in the door of a tattoo shop and see what's going on and do that. And so there was this mystique still about what's going on behind the door of that, you know, tattoo shop. And since then, through TV shows and other, you know, things, it's become more, you know, popular, but also a lot more people are more knowledgeable about what to expect with tattoos.
It was much more of a stigma. It classed you in a different way, I guess, is the best way to put it. Maybe not a stigma, but you were a particular type of person to have had tattoos. And now I think you see it all over the place. You know, you'll see doctors or professors or bankers with a tattoo. And it's not just, you know, like young software engineers or baristas or something, right? That's not the only people who have that now. So I think it's more common. Maybe, I don't know if common is the right word, but you see it more often, and it's not as, it doesn't mark you as sort of like working class or criminal class like it used to, for sure.
So once enough people had tattoos, then how do you hire a workforce if you've really cut your population, right? So you only hire people with no visible tattoos, and now you just don't have enough people working because so many people have visible tattoos. So it's sort of pushing that envelope open slowly, right? And so maybe somebody with a subtle tattoo and then a little more obvious one. And some positions, I mean, maybe it would be more conservative where you're working at Wall Street, you can't have a neck tattoo. But, you know, if you're working at Ocean City, you can. And so I think it's just changed slowly over time as it's become more acceptable.
In part, the reason people are against it is its permanence. So I think that there's this idea that when you're young, you want to do different things that you're going to regret when you're older. And I think older people are hypersensitive to that, and that includes tattoos.
You want to read that out loud? No.
My mom doesn't like it, but I don't care. She doesn't really make a big deal out of it. She, even when I got them, basically her response was like my coworker. She was like, oh, let me see it. Oh, that's interesting. And I knew she disapproved, right? She's very religious, and she's one of those people who will take that section of the Bible about not marking your body, or I forget what the verse is, but she takes that very seriously, like this is, you know. And I was like, well, you know, Mom, I'm sorry, that's not really my holy book anymore, and I don't particularly care what it says about tattooing, even if you choose to interpret it that way. But my daughter thinks they're cool, you know. She just sort of accepts it, I guess. You know, I mean, I first got tattoos when she was about 6. So she, more or less, she doesn't really remember me without tattoos.
I wish that it could be more accepted than it is now. Like, I wish people could just, you know, not see people for what's on their, you know, on their body, but for who they are, and you know, what they have to offer.
I think, like a lot of things, the pendulum swings, right? And then somewhere it finds a happy medium. And so it's more acceptable than it's ever been in our culture to have body modification. So I think we're still swinging towards that way, right? Anybody can get them and in more places. And as long as they're not terribly offensive, then that's fine. And then at some point, I wondered though, at what point will the rebels be people with no tattoos, right? So it was such a sign of rebellion and really like even overcoming fear. So many people are like, oh, I'm afraid of needles, or they're afraid to get it done. But good, maybe it shouldn't be for everybody, and you should face your fear and get it done if that's what you're going to do. But then at what point have so many people done that that you rebel by going, I'm not going to get pierced, I'm not going to get tattooed?
People get trapped in their ideas of what a body can and should look like. And all of that's created by us. We've decided and we've made rules and we've kind of like policed bodies and regimented bodies, and we're like, bodies can't do this and bodies can't look like this. And I think letting some of that go could be very freeing for people who seem to misunderstand it. And it's like, why? I mean, there's something kind of amazing about choosing willfully this pain over other kinds of pain that you don't have control over, that I think we don't talk about very often and is usually people's first question and the first thing they're very concerned about. And then they'll say, I could never do that. I could never get all those. That would hurt too much. Like, since when are we the kind of humanity that chooses against pain? I feel like we always choose pain.
I didn't think I was going to be this big of a part of someone's life coming into being a tattoo artist. There's a lot of my clients that have had family members pass on, and then we do pieces for them. And it's almost like, you know, I get to kind of spend a little bit of time in their family and their relationship with this person that has passed on. And it is a lot of fun. You know, and then there's sometimes that, you know, you're tattooing someone, you become almost like their shrink for a little bit. So you listen to their problems, you know, kind of like, it's kind of like a little confessional in here. So it's fun. I enjoy being part of someone's life like that. It's a lot of fun.
It's typical now for people to have tattoos. So back in the day, it was kind of like, oh, do you have a tattoo or not? I think nowadays it's becoming more commonplace to where it's more like, you know, so what's your tattoo? You know, it's almost odd not to have a tattoo.
I was the first tattoo parlor I'd seen in Guatemala, so I was curious. So I go in and I'm looking through their work and I see that they're good, you know, they're pretty talented guys. And then I went back to the hotel while she was getting the massage and I started thinking, you know, I should get a tattoo. You know, that's like a massage for me, right? That's a cool, relaxing vacation type of thing to do. So I started looking through through stuff, like what could I get that's not too big that they might be able to fit in? And I found this image of an Ace of Spades with Lemmy's head in it, you know, after the famous song. And I thought, oh, that's a pretty cool image. You know, it's not very big. I could probably get it in an hour. So I walked back down there and I said, you know, I wonder if you guys have any appointments. And they said, well, we don't. I guess it was about it was like a Tuesday. And they said, we don't have any until next Tuesday. And I said, well, I'm flying out next Tuesday morning. You know, I can't do it, but okay. And then the woman that was working at the front desk, she said, well, what are you thinking about getting? And I said, well, I was thinking about getting this image of Lemmy, which is a playing card with that image on it. And she looked at it and she was like, hold on a minute. And she walked, it was like the tattoo shop. You walked up a spiral staircase and they were working up on this loft. And so she went up there and they spoke in Spanish for a little bit. And then the owner, Ruben, like sticks his head over the thing. He's like, we could totally fit you in for that, you know? It turned out that those guys were like huge heavy metal fans, right? And both of the artists. And they just stayed open an extra hour the next night. And I came back and got the tattoo during that time. And it was, you know, and then it was cool because I was in Antigua on this cool vacation. And now I have this, you know, not only did I get the mark, I mean, Lemmy was pretty influential to me personally. So that one does have some meaning. But I also got to mark this great vacation I was on, you know, and I think it's much more interesting than getting a massage. I just don't like massages.
So there are many different cultures around the world. And if you think about in the ancient times when communication was really limited, how very interesting it is that so many places came up with similar ideas to retouch the body. And that it's a primitive urge, right? So just like birds have pretty feathers and animals have fur, like we had this retouching instinct, right? So we met our basic survival needs and then we wanted to decorate our bodies. And the other part of that I think is more contemporary is the reasons why we do that. And so in ancient traditions and still now, we tend to want to mark our bodies as milestones. So it means something.
The quality of work keeps growing and just the sense of like safe practice keeps growing and the awareness of it. So that's just going to evolve it at a higher level and probably always evolve it to do so.
young people are doing this really cool thing. We're redefining what's professional. We're redefining what work is. In 10 years, our idea of what work and what working people look like will be completely different. And I think that's a good thing, because if you think about like professors at the university, who do you picture? You picture old man with elbow patches, being very professorial, maybe with like a pipe. You don't picture me, and that's a problem. And I think that young people help change the image of what professional looks like, and I think that's a really good thing. It lets more people into the professional workplace. It lets things be more creative, more open.
Like the first, like I have a Black Widow mark on my wrist that all my friends got when we were young, and I just wanted to do, I always said if I ever get tattoos, I'm gonna get a Black Widow mark on my wrist, because that was kind of like, it wasn't a gang, but it was just our group of pals, right? But this tattoo, this part of my arm was the first big tattoo that I got, and I just saw it in a book and I thought it was cool looking. It's an archaeological drawing of the first king that they found that they think was buried as a god back in somewhere near Palestine, but this is like in 8000 BC. So I just thought the drawing was really cool, you know, but they sort of, you can see in there how they put rocks on top of the skeleton to keep it in the ground, but they also worshiped it. And I just saw that in a book that I was reading about. It was a really interesting book, but I just thought that would be a cool tattoo. And then that just sort of decided this whole arm, right? It's just all skeletons so far. And that, you know, then I saw this. This one is, kind of see it, it's a skeleton that was buried in a bog in Great Britain. I think it was in Scotland, but it might have been Wales. Anyway, it's like a Frankenskeleton. It's composed of like five or six different bodies. And then they threw these bodies. This is really puzzling to the researchers who found it. They don't know why these bodies got put back together and then thrown into a bog. But as soon as I saw it, I was like, I got to put that next to the other skeleton that I have, right? It just totally fits. Now, I could make up some story about how that all connects together, but I just really got it because it looked cool.
You know, the TV programs and stuff like that, that actually brought a lot of the tattoo history into the mainstream media, where people could actually kind of see where tattooing was at the dawn of tattooing, back in like the 40s and 50s. You know, that's where, you know, you get a lot of like the sailors and stuff like that going port to port and getting their traditional style tattoos. And then as it kind of grew from there and came into more of the mainstream media, coming into like the rock scene with everybody with their tattoos, and now like the TV programs are great because a lot more people are seeing that it's not just for, you know, that type of, you know, I guess, drag of society just to get tattooed. A lot of these people are doctors, lawyers, you know, high-end people that are getting tattooed, and a lot of it is just phenomenal artwork. And I think a lot of people are seeing that from the shows, and people are just kind of blown away with what some of us can do with a tattoo machine and just the artwork behind it.
Well, that was one of the reasons I never got one when I was young, is I was constantly searching for, like, you know, you might say a soulmate of a tattoo, right? A tattoo that I would love just the same way till the end of time. And I think about some of the ideas I had, and I'm like, I wouldn't think that was that cool anymore. But if I'd gotten it, that'd just be the tattoo that you have, right? And in a lot of ways, it is just a kind of a commitment, you know? You just decide, this is what I'm gonna get today, and then it's gonna be there, and I'm gonna have to make some sort of peace with it, you know, even if I outgrow it.
The idea that the younger generation chooses aesthetics as like a whole way of life, in a way that an older generation didn't. And so I think on accident, it becomes a lifestyle. Yeah.